Nevada. So y'all have to stay tuned. Any other questions?
How often do you break strings?
All the time. Daily occurrence. I was practicing on this harp yesterday, actually, and two strings broke. So, you know, part of that is just because I'm such a powerful player. No, I mean because it happens so often, you get really used to it. So.
Do you keep harps at home and at school?
At the U of A, where I study and here, there's a few school harps, so students can harp majors can practice on those when they're, you know, in between their classes, and then generally most harps just have their own at home as well.
Is this your harp?
No, the Kathy Blayton is the head of harp here, and she was gracious enough to let me borrow it. It's one of the University of Utah's harps.
So is yours in Arizona?
Yes, yeah.
Is it easy to move from one harp to another?
Good question. Yeah, that is a good question. All harps are a little bit different, just tone-wise, and so it does take a little bit of time to get used to them. But luckily, I'm a grad student, so I just took this week off, and I was here all week, so I had a chance to play on this one a little bit and get used to it. But I've done a few national competitions, and when you do that, they give you just about an hour with the harp right before you play. So that's not ideal, but it doesn't take that long to get used to it. They're not that different. But that was a good question.
There's a lot of variability in sizes of harps as well, right?
Yeah. So there's, when you start out on the harp, so I started when I was about 7, you start on a little troubadour harp, which if you notice, this harp has pedals. Actually, this ties in really well with my next piece. So the modern harp was designed to have pedals so that when you move one, there's rods that run up the column that are connected to each pedal. So there's 7 pedals, one for each note of the scale. And the rods run up here and then connect to all these discs. So this is the D pedal, and if you see as I move it, every single D disc goes. So that's how you get accidentals on a harp. Because there's three notches for each pedal. There's flat, natural, and sharp. So as you move it, those discs tighten against the string and raise the pitch. So it's quite a complicated instrument, I must say.
You said modern harp, so when did the modern harp come out? What's different about that?
So like I was saying, you start on a troubadour harp when you're younger.
How long were you on the troubadour?
What's that?
How long were you on that one?
I was on there for about, like from 8 to 7 to about 13, I think. And those harps, sorry, hold on. It's a little bit hard to focus on.
You were 10 when you got your pedal harp, Kate.
Oh, I was? Okay. 7 to 10.
It's about 3 years.
Well, that's right, because I had, there's a pedal harp that's even smaller than this. So I was kind of short growing up. So I had to have a mini pedal harp first before I graduated to the concert grand. So what was the question? I'm sorry.
How long was the modern harp?
Oh, yeah, okay. So the troubadour harp just has levers. It doesn't have any pedals, so you have to do it manually. And the modern harp was, well, originally, the way you get accidentals is they have a triple string harp. So there were 3 rows of strings. And then, I've tried playing on one and you just go across. I don't know how people do it. But that's so they would tune the the different notes to the different accidentals they needed, and that's the way that they would do it. But luckily, they got their act together and invented the pedal harp, because it's much easier.
So since Bach wasn't around when the pedal harp was invented, who transcribed this, your lute suite? Did you just play it off of his lute?
No, or it was transcribed by Marie Claire Jumet, I think. So the lute, the modern equivalent of the lute, which that piece was written for, is the guitar. And people say that's you can get the closest sound to a guitar rather than transcribing from a piano or something else that Bach wrote for. Because Bach never wrote anything for the J.S. Bach never wrote anything specifically for the harp. The most famous composer from that era that wrote for the harp was actually Handel, and he wrote a full concerto. But the harps just weren't loud enough, and they weren't reliable enough, and there weren't enough harpists available.
Just do the nod again.
Yeah, I know some symphonies they have microphones.